But thanks for having me. If anybody has any questions, like I said, just basically just raise your hand and I'll try to call on you as soon as I possibly can. So who here actually feels like they are under surveillance pretty regularly?
Everyone inside of Occupy is,
though. Everyone inside of Occupy. How many people here have been arrested and had their, at their court date, they had their phone taken into the back room? How many people here had their retina scanned? Wow. So you guys are actually, in a sense, the canaries in the coal mine, right? Because the incentives are all lined up against you. Anybody see on the subway, link your MetroCard to your debit card, right? And like auto refill? This is a concept which is key to everything we'll talk about today, and it's called linkability. Take one piece of data and link it to another piece of data. So for example, if you have your MetroCard and you have your debit card, you have those things and you can draw a line between them, right? So that's like not a scary thing, except your bank card is tied to everything else that you do during the day. So now they know where you're going, when you make purchases. So when they decide to target you, they can actually recreate your exact steps with a MetroCard and with the credit card alone. Like literally where you go and what you buy. And potentially, by linking that data with other people on similar travel plans, they can figure out who you talked to and who you met with. When you then take cell phone data, which logs your location, and you link up purchasing data, MetroCard data, and your debit card, you start to get what you could call metadata in aggregate over a person's life. And metadata in aggregate is content. It tells a story about you, which is made up of facts, but is not necessarily true. So for example, just because you were on the corner and all those data points point to it, it doesn't mean you committed the crime. So it's important to note that if someone has a perception of you having done a thing, it will now follow you for the rest of your life. So just keep in mind that what happens to you guys, for example, with fingerprints and retinal scans and photographs, that is what is going to happen to people in the future when they resist policy changes and when they try to protest in a totally constitutionally protected way.